It's officially Heisman week. Well, sort of. Normally the Heisman Trophy presentation is on a Saturday, but this year it's on a Tuesday, so it's 1 week from today. For the next week, I'm going to be posting one Heisman video a day, leading up until next Tuesday when we find out who the next winner is. I thought it'd be a fun idea to kick off this series by looking back at the biggest blowouts in Heisman Trophy voting history. There have been a lot of obvious winners in the past, but what players have won in the biggest landslide of votes? Let's go take a look. Before we get to today's video, make sure you smash that subscribe button and turn on those notifications. I'll be posting Heisman videos every day for the next week leading up to the ceremony, so make sure you don't miss another one. So how we're determining these rankings are the players who had the biggest gap in points from first place to second place. All right, let's kick off this countdown. We begin at number 10 with Roger Staubach, who won the award in 1963 while playing for Navy. The junior quarterback received a total of 517 first place votes and finished with a total of 1,860 points. Second place went to Billy Lothridge, quarterback for Georgia Tech. He finished with only 504 points, giving Staubach a win of 1,356 points. He became the second player from Navy to ever win the Heisman Trophy. He sure lit it up for them that year, as he threw for a total of 1,700 yards while completing 66% of his passes. In 11 games, he threw 7 touchdowns with 7 interceptions. He did a lot of damage on the ground though, as he rushed for nearly 400 yards with 9 rushing touchdowns. Staubach finished 1963 4th in passing yards, 20th in passing touchdowns, but was first among quarterbacks in rushing yards and second in rushing touchdowns. Moving to number 9, we go back a few more years. Howard Cassidy, running back from Ohio State, took home the Heisman in 1955. He finished with 594 first place votes and a total of 2,219 points. Jim Swank, running back at TCU, came in second place with 742 points, a total difference of 1,477 points. Cassidy was the third player from Ohio State to ever win the Heisman Trophy. He finished the season with 958 rushing yards and 14 rushing touchdowns. At the time of winning, Cassidy's 14 rushing touchdowns were the third most ever by a running back who won the Heisman. He won in his senior season, but it was the second time he was a finalist for the award. He came in third place the previous year. Now, moving back to recent times, Jameis Winston comes in at number 8. He won the Heisman as a freshman back in 2013. He took in 668 first place votes and a total of 2,205 points. AJ McCarron, who played quarterback in Alabama, finished in second place with 704 points for a difference of 1,501 points. Winston finished the season with over 4,000 passing yards and 40 passing touchdowns. He also added 200 rushing yards and 4 rushing touchdowns as well. He finished 9th in passing yards and 2nd in passing touchdowns. However, what gave Winston the edge was the fact that he led Florida State to an undefeated season and a BCS national championship. After winning the award his freshman season, Winston finished in 6th place his sophomore year. Number 7 on our list goes to Vinny Testaverde, quarterback for Miami in 1986. He received 678 total first place votes and finished with 2,213 total points. Paul Palmer, running back for Temple, came in 2nd place. He finished with 672 points for a total difference of 1,541 points. Testaverde became the first player in Miami Hurricanes history to ever win the Heisman Trophy. He completed 63% of his passes for 2,500 yards and 26 passing touchdowns. He also added 4 rushing touchdowns to give him a total of 30 touchdowns on the year. Testaverde finished 13th in the nation in passing yards, but finished 1st in passing touchdowns by a pretty big margin. What really helped his case was the fact that Miami was the best team all season. They were ranked number 1 for majority of the year and went undefeated. Ultimately, they lost to Penn State in the Fiesta Bowl and came up just short of a championship. Overall, Testaverde is 6th in Miami history in passing yards and 5th in passing touchdowns. Ricky Williams comes in at number 6 on this list. Back in 1998, the running back from Texas finished with 714 first place votes and 2,355 total points. Second place went to Michael Bishop, quarterback from Kansas State, as he finished with a total of 792 points for a total difference of 1,563 points. Ricky Williams became the second player from Texas to ever win the Heisman. He had one of the best seasons we had ever seen from a running back up to that point. He finished the season with 2,124 rushing yards, which at the time was the 5th most ever by a running back in a single season. Now it ranks him at number 15. He finished the season with 27 rushing touchdowns, which at the time was the 4th most ever in a season. Now it ranks him 14th all time. However, still 20 years later, it's still one of the greatest seasons we've ever seen from a running back in college football. Before we get to the top 5, if you could please take a second and give this video a thumbs up, I would greatly appreciate it. It really helps share the video with more college football fans, and it only takes 1 second to do. Number 5 on our list goes to the last wide receiver to win the Heisman Trophy, Desmond Howard. He won the award sport for Michigan back in 1991. He finished with 640 first place votes and a total of 2,077 points. Casey Weldon, quarterback from Florida State, finished in second place with a total of 503 points, a difference of 1,574 points. Howard was the second player from Michigan to ever win the Heisman. He finished the season with 62 catches for 985 yards. Ironically, both of those numbers were actually less than he had the season prior, when he didn't even finish top 10 in the Heisman voting. Howard caught 19 touchdowns, which was a career best for him. He also added nearly 200 rushing yards with 2 rushing touchdowns. In addition, he totaled 700 return yards and had a kick return for a touchdown and a punt return for a touchdown. Howard finished the season 13th in the country in receptions and 11th in the country in receiving yards, but his 19 receiving touchdowns led the country and his 21 total touchdowns were second. We have our second Florida State player on this list as Charlie Ward comes in at number 4. He won the Heisman back in 1993, receiving 740 first place votes and 2,310 points. Heath Shuler, quarterback at Tennessee, finished with 688 total points, a differential of 1,622. Charlie Ward finished the season by throwing for more than 3,000 yards with 27 passing touchdowns and only 4 interceptions. He also added over 300 rushing yards and 4 rushing touchdowns. He finished 14th in the nation in passing yards and 6th in passing touchdowns. Those numbers weren't the best for a quarterback in 1993. He was the quarterback for the clear-cut number 1 team in the country. Florida State was ranked number 1 every week until they finally lost in Week 10. The Seminoles went on to defeat Nebraska in the Orange Bowl and won the national championship. Before I get to the 3 biggest blowouts in the history of the Heisman Trophy, drop a comment down below and guess who you think the 3 biggest are. I'll give you a hint. 2 have come in the 2000s, and the other one was by a running back. Moving on to number 3, Troy Smith from Ohio State won back in 2006. That season, he received 801 first place votes, the third most first place votes ever for a ceremony. He finished with 2,540 total points. Coming in second place was Arkansas running back Darren McFadden, who finished with 878 total points, a difference of 1,662 points. Smith threw for only 2,500 yards, but threw 30 touchdowns compared to only 6 interceptions. After rushing for 11 touchdowns in 2005, he had only 1 rushing touchdown in 2006. He finished 38th in the country in passing yards and 8th in touchdown passes. Just like I mentioned with Florida State earlier, Ohio State was the number 1 team in the country all season, so that's what really helped Troy Smith win the award. They won their first 12 games before losing to Florida in the national championship. Looking back at it, it's weird to see why Smith ran away with the vote. Sure, you can make the case he was deserving, but after hearing his resume, the third biggest blowout in Heisman history, it definitely seems a tad questionable to me. Coming in at number 2 is USC running back OJ Simpson. He took home the Heisman in 1968 when he received 855 first place votes, the most first place votes of all time. He totaled 2,853 points. Coming in second place was Purdue running back Leroy Keyes, who finished with 1,103 total points, a difference of 1,750. After finishing in second place in 1967, OJ took home the Heisman the following year. He rushed for just under 1,900 yards with 23 rushing touchdowns. He led the country in rushing yards, having 300 more than the next closest running back. His 23 touchdowns were also the most by any running back in the country. At the time, this was arguably the greatest season we'd ever seen from a running back, so there's a reason as to why he ran away with the award. For 50 years, OJ Simpson held on to the record for the biggest blowout in the history of the Heisman Trophy. That is, until last year. Coming in at number 1 with the biggest blowout in the history of the Heisman Trophy is LSU quarterback Joe Burrow, who took home the trophy in 2019. He finished with 841 first place votes, the second most of all time. He finished with 2,608 points. Jalen Hurts, quarterback for Oklahoma, came in second place with 762 points, a difference of 1,846 points, the biggest differential in Heisman voting history. Joe Burrow had arguably the greatest season we've ever seen from a quarterback in college football. He threw for 5,671 yards, tied for the third most in a single season in FBS history. He was less than 200 yards away from setting the record. His 60 passing touchdowns set a new record, topping Colt Brennan's 58 back in 2006. For good measure, Burrow added nearly 400 yards on the ground with 5 rushing touchdowns as well. He led LSU to an undefeated season, including a national championship. Like I said, it's arguably the greatest season we've ever seen from a college football quarterback, and I doubt we see one like it anytime soon. Well, that wraps up this top 10 countdown. What was the biggest shock to you on this list? Was there a player who you thought would have been on this list that wasn't? Drop a comment down below and share with me your thoughts. If you haven't done so yet, make sure you subscribe and turn on those notifications so you don't miss a video during my Heisman week. As always, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you all tomorrow with my next Heisman video.